Come on, buddy. You can do it. You can do it. It's your favorite. There we go. Ah, there we go. So that's good. That's a good sign. To the channel. I hope everybody is doing okay. I am doing great. Back to work and things are going well. And things are even better today because I get to introduce you guys to, will you stop biting my ear? I get to introduce you guys to the newest member of the family. And I gotta tell you guys, it is one of my dream reptiles. I'm so excited to have it. If you've seen the thumbnail, probably the title probably has already told you, it's already given it away, but it is a baby rhino iguana. And I'm super juiced. I'm so excited to show you guys this little fella. I know what you guys are probably thinking, because in one of my last videos, I said that iguanas were actually one of the worst pets that you could possibly get. But that video, one, was for beginners, and two, I did tell you in that video that a rhino iguana was something that I wanted. I never expected to get the iguana this soon, though. My girlfriend, lovely girlfriend behind the camera, surprised me with it for our anniversary, and I couldn't be happier. So today, what I'm going to do is I'm kind of going to show you guys how I plan on taming this little guy or girl. We don't know the sex yet. Taming what him, her, down. And I'm kind of just go through the ropes of how I've been doing it lately. She doesn't want to be around me right now. I'm gonna just kind of go through those ropes. I have to take him out as well, so you guys will get to see him, because I am going to clean out the cage and just redo it really quick. So I wanted to show you guys how the cage is set up first. So I wanted to show you guys the cage. The first thing you might notice in the cage is that I use a newspaper. And in one of my previous videos, I said I didn't like using newspaper because it just looks ugly. But when getting a new reptile, ever since my mite episode, I've been extra cautious in making sure that that didn't happen again. This iguana is going to outgrow this setup extremely quickly. So don't think that this is like anything close to a permanent setup. This is just the beginning. Iguanas need a lot of space, which is why I put them in the one of the worst pet reptiles video. But with that being said, I'm going to take the iguana out and kind of show you guys how I plan on taming down the iguana. So let's do that right now. All right, so this cage isn't ideal for iguanas or any type of lizard or anything, snake, lizard, anything, because it opens from the top, and I don't necessarily enjoy having cages that open from the top, because when you reach in to an animal from above, they kind of consider that more of a threat, and it's easier when you're reaching in just from the side. It keeps the animal a little bit more calm, but gotta make do with what we got. So right now, the cage that I have opens from the top. So what I do is I pretty much just open up the cage slow. And this little guy is still small, and he's still skittish, still doesn't fully trust me, and this whole process is just about building trust. And so what you wanna do is you don't really wanna make too many fast, sudden movements, but I do wanna constantly be talking to him, because I need him to get used to my voice and not be afraid when you know, my voice is around or anything like that. So then what I do is I get just kinda one of his favorite foods. This is mustard greens, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to hand feed him. Now, usually it takes him a while to take it out of my hand. I don't know if he's going to want to with the camera right there, but we're going to try it. And what I'm going to do is just slowly kind of put the food in there right next to his face, and we're going to see if he'll take it. He's looking at it, but I think the camera kind of is like making him a little confused. Oh, I see you right there, buddy. Look, you know the drill. The good thing is that even with my hand right here next to him, you see he's not freaking out, not trying to run away. Oh, tasting it. And that's actually a good sign right off the bat. Let's try again. Sometimes when I reposition, so let's try one more time. So we're gonna come from this side. Oh, you see how he jumped? Okay, so don't wanna try to follow him too quickly, but I do want to kind of keep my hand in there and just show him that this is not a threat. So he's a little nervous. I think it's because of the camera, because usually it might take a little bit, but usually he just eats it straight out of my hand. So I'm just gonna tell you what I usually do. So what I would usually do is I would feed him some food, and then as he's eating it, I would just start to pet him a little bit. And that usually calms him down. He actually seems to enjoy it. His eyes close and he like sits there kind of like a dog would. So that's what I would usually do. So right now he's not doing it. I might try one more time. If that doesn't work, I am gonna still try the petting thing just to kind of calm him down, show him that I'm not a threat, and then I'll take him out of the cage. All right, guys, so this is the next day. So what happened yesterday was, as I was trying to you know, pet the iguana and feeding it, he got scared. And I think he got scared because of the camera. And so he got scared and he ran into a corner. And so in that situation, the last thing that I wanna do is to try to force it and to scare him even more. So I basically just decided just to leave him there. And if he came out again, then I would keep filming. If not, then I would wait another day to film. So today is the next day. He's out again, and I'm gonna try it again. And that's the thing, guys. It's all about repetition and building that trust. And so, you know, it's baby steps. I don't wanna force him. If he decides he's gonna let me pick him up today, then I'll do it. If not, that's okay, and hopefully he'll just let me pet him. It's just baby steps and not trying to rush things too much. The trust building, just like human relationships with pets and with reptiles, it takes a long time. Unfortunately, I don't have my camera woman, so I'm gonna have to try to do this one-handed. So we'll see how that goes. It might not go as planned, but we're gonna try our best. So let's see what happens today. So like I said, guys, the camera is already kind of putting him on edge. And so, I mean, that's, you know, that's, he doesn't know what this is yet. So this is something that's very new for him. And this is part of the reason why I said I don't like having cages that open from the top, because he's looking at this from the top, thinking that it could possibly be some type of predator. And he doesn't realize that this is not a threat yet, and that I am not a threat yet. So I'm still gonna try to feed him some food and see if he'll at least take it. Come on, buddy. You can do it. You can do it, it's your favorite. There we go. Ah, there we go. So that's good. That's a good sign. That is a very good sign that he ate it right out of my hand. And usually, when he eats the first, usually once he gets that taste, he realizes, oh, this guy's not trying to hurt me. And he usually will keep going. Good job, buddy. Now let's see if he'll let me pet him. And usually he will. Ah, there we go. So then after I do that, what I do is I make him his food. And rhino iguanas are strictly herbivores. They can eat some type of insect sometimes, but their main diet is going to be greens and vegetables and fruits. So I make him his food, and then after I'm done
hand feeding him and kind of trying to just work with him and gain that trust a little bit, I will put that food in there so that he knows that it is feeding time. So the reason why I do that and I give him food afterwards is so that he associates, you know, okay, if I let this giant person kind of mess with me and touch me and pet me, then if I make it through that, then I'm going to get some food afterwards. And I want that association to be there. So I just want to make sure that he's always having positive experiences with me. I don't want him to get scared. If he gets scared and run away, I don't chase after him. I leave him where he's at, let him calm down. He'll eventually come back out, and then I can try again and I can feed him and pet him a little bit. So it's all about positive experiences. You got to remember, you are a giant to these animals, and so you want to make them as comfortable as possible. So that's what I try to do every single time. That's also why, as much as I wanted to take him out and show you guys him in my hand, I don't want to force it. I don't want to just pick him up and grab him, because that's going to freak him out. I want him to stay calm and basically let me and ease my way into that. I've picked him up a few times. That was when he was calm. He wasn't trying to run away from me. The camera wasn't out. So those are all a lot of factors. And with this lizard, it's just about working with him or her every single day. Every single day, making little bits of progress every single day to get that end result of a super, super tame lizard or animal. So that is it, everybody. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys enjoyed meeting my new rhino iguana, one of my dream lizards. I'm so excited, I can't wait. Until it gets bigger, until it grows, until it gets tame. I just can't wait to show you guys the progress that I'm going to be making with this lizard. What did you guys think about the way that I try to tame my lizards? Do you guys agree with those ways? Do you guys disagree with them? What are your ways that you guys like to tame and like to work with your animals? Let me know in the comments. I'm always open to new ideas. One more thing before I go. I wanted to give a major, major shout out to everybody who has supported this channel, to everybody who has watched my videos. I just had my first video hit 1,000 views, and I know it doesn't seem like a lot in like a general YouTube perspective, but for me personally, it's a lot, and I just it's awesome to see the page grow and the channel grow, and I hope you guys are enjoying these videos. I do it for fun, but I put a lot of effort into them, and I really want you guys to enjoy them and to see one of my videos, my box turtle video to be exact. One that I never even expected to be popular, but to see that video hit 1,000 views, it really makes me happy, and it really feels like I'm doing something to helpful. I'm doing something useful, and it's an awesome feeling to have. So just wanted to tell you guys, thank you so much for the support. Don't forget to like, don't forget to comment, and please, please, please share this video. Also hit that subscribe button. Until next time, everybody, my name is Pierce LaValle. This is Pierce's Planet, and it's always all about the reps, baby. Peace. Guys, look what we have here. For those of you who don't know what this is, it is my animal plastics cage. It finally came in. For those of you who watch the channel, you guys know how long I've been waiting for this cage, and it is finally here. So be on the lookout and stay tuned. I'm gonna have a lot of upgrades coming soon. The Burmese Python's gonna get upgraded, the Blue Beauty's gonna get upgraded, and the Anaconda is gonna get upgraded. So you guys do not wanna miss that. Those are gonna be some good videos right there.